Hello and welcome to another video for linmob.net. I was recently asked what the progress of Plasma Mobile was in the past weeks, because it's been a while since I made a video on Plasma Mobile. And well, I was like, well, maybe I can finally get myself to put PostMarket OS on this BQ across X5, which is supported, well, I was too lazy to do that, and then I found out that there was a new Manjaro dev release on October 18th, and I just put that on an SD card and tried it earlier. So for this video, I just put it on a different SD card because that first SD card I had it on was a particularly slow one. As you know, SD card speeds on the PinePhone are a tad slower than on the eMMC. The eMMC has a read-write performance, I think, of around 80 megabytes. At least that's the number that floated around for the 16 gigabyte eMMC on the 2 gigabyte RAM PinePhone, and SD card performance is limited to around 30 megabytes per second. So having a really slow SD card can slow this down even further, and that's why I decided to take one that's a bit faster, not super fast, but should be fast enough for the PinePhone, and use that for this video so that I don't completely misrepresent this new Manjaro build that, again, is not even an alpha release, it's just a dev build. And for that, it's running really well. I had dev builds of Plasma Mobile and KDE Neon and Manjaro with Plasma Mobile that wouldn't even launch a graphical interface. And this one, as you can see, totally does. And yeah, it has a couple things that should, well, that I always hide when I have them on my PinePhones. These here, Qt Assistant, Qt Designer, Qt Linguist, and Qt Viewer. These are basically maybe got in there because they are built dependencies for so many programs. And there's also Megapixels, which is this GTK based camera. So we can see, okay, GTK based apps run just fine on the Plasma Mobile PinePhone 2. The same, I think, hopefully goes for Firefox. By the way, I really like those splash screens. For sure, that then true. Would really help to know, oh, there's an app starting. I mean, it's a bit of a showstopper, of course, but I think it helps overall, as long as it's not taking too long. And look at that, the keyboard. Well, we have graphical glitches here. The keyboard generally seems to work. So in Firefox, which wasn't the case before with the old keyboard. This is the Malit keyboard. It's written with double A. I don't know how to properly spell it, and my website is not linmob.bet. It's not a bet. It's not about money. Just about Linux smartphones. Yeah, there are glitches. Well, we've proven that now. Now let me just try and install let me try perform an update and install some more software here. And I think I'm just going... by the way, I'm not using Discover because Discover has proven to be pretty slow, and I just prefer doing it over the terminal because that's the method that will work even if your graphical user interface fails. So it may be helpful to see that. So I'm installing gedit here, which is this GNOME desktop text editor. just to see how well text input on GDK apps now works on this Plasma mobile build of Manjaro. Okay, this looks like it's going to take a while, and there's still this annoying thing with this terminal app that you don't have that home button anymore visible and you have to tap up there to get down there. I hope they get around to fixing it sometime soon, because that one really bugs me. But yeah, this time it worked properly on camera. I tried earlier and had a really hard time. So, well, the apps we have here, I think I had a look at them some time ago. Calendari, the calendar app, may have been updated in a meaningful way since my last video. I think they had a 1.2 release. Let's see if that changed anything graphically. Now, of course, I don't really remember what it looked like. Yeah, that looks a bit different. So, yeah, it's pretty nice, but I haven't really looked into it and therefore haven't figured out a way yet how to get this to sync with, for example, my Nextcloud CalDAV server, which would be really the feature I would be looking for. Let's see if something like this is in that settings app, which is, well, I'm not super happy with GNOME settings, but this one is not better, to say it that way. And there's here add new account. But then there's nothing. Maybe there's a component missing that's not installed. I mean, this is just developer release. It's not even meant for normal use. So I would like to see whether Nextcloud login works now. But well, I think we'll have to postpone that for a later image of Manjaro, or maybe even a completely different distribution. So this is Anglefish, which is my favorite web browser on Fosh and Arch Linux ARM. I wrote a blog post about this a long time ago, where I also wrote up how to set it as the default browser. But this is my Fosh install, but it started the clocks up for whatever reason. And not Anglefish. Yeah, you must not mistap. So here, that's Anglefish running there, and doesn't seem to start on this build. But then Anglefish can have issues and sometimes requires you to set some environment variables and stuff. So yeah. So let's just see in this multitasking menu whether our install went through. That's looking like it's still going on. But did that in the background, which is nice. And now it's not, well, I shouldn't be so impatient. Just close a few apps here, maybe. Because 3 GB is more than 2, but it's not unlimited. Yeah, so Firefox really has some weird glitches here. I think I'm going to reboot later to see if that upgrade fixes anything or breaks it completely. And then that's it for this. Hi, so yesterday my update failed, so I tried again today, and guess what? I upgraded, I rebooted, and Manjaro came up again. And this year, by the way, is Plasma Mobile on PostmarketOS, which is still in an older version, and I just had to skip an earlier attempt of making a video because I started swearing because I don't get out of this. Yeah, it's that search thing is really annoying. I really dislike it when I lose that main element of navigation, you know, that bottom bar, to leave an app. That's really not what should happen, and unfortunately that's what happens in the terminal app and in that search widget as well. So yeah, that's not good. So I think maybe I can get out of here by just opening an app. So let's just type, I don't know, disk for discover. Oh no, there's still a K in there, and discover doesn't start with a K. It's one of the few apps of KDE that doesn't. And so let me just log in here, and yeah, that seems like it's still working. Let's see if we've got less glitches than before the update. Firefox was really glitchy yesterday. I don't know. Ah, I got out of that hellhole. That's great. Now Firefox seems to be a tad better now. Two tabs open. Privacy notice. But the keyboard seems to have some new bug. Just try it again. Yeah, no keyboard. That's not good, because that's like the old days, like it used to be here on Postmarket, because that old keyboard simply does not support GDK input, GDK3 input fields at all. So there's no way you're getting that to work there. Let's see if Anglefish works, but I think that wasn't updated, so it should be just as bad as it used to be before. Now that seems to working fine, but apparently the upgrade of Manjaro broke the keyboard. Okay, so never mind. Manjaro dev release, don't upgrade it. It will fail. We'll have less glitches, but without a working keyboard, doesn't really make sense. Postmarket, well, as long as you can get by only using Plasma apps, which are not many more than those pre-installed here, Spacebar for SMS, Terminal, Wave for Music, Coco for Images, I think, and Nota for notes, and Boohoo also for notes, Calendari for the calendar, and so on. You're going to have a tough time. What I'm going to try is to see whether Megapixels runs fine. You know, that camera app that has been created for Plasma Mobile. And then I'm gonna pause again and see if we can run KDE Neon, or in which state KDE Neon currently is, if it's also broken or whether it works currently. See you soon. So whatever will happen, this is the last take of this video, I think, and so that's my Plasma Mobile point for, and I really need to be more patient, I think. Well, maybe I can look in like that. Okay, this is KDE Neon, and I've gotten Discover somewhere where it can do its upgrades. So let's see how those go through on this daily build. Already so many updates, but yeah, software is progressing quickly. And I also managed to upgrade this Postmarket OS install, because I wanted to try megapixels, and then it complained, oh, there's a conflict between KDE, GTK, blah, blah, something, or CLI config, KDE CLI config, I think it was, and yeah, that, so I upgraded, and that got me the new 5.20 version of Plasma on Postmarket OS, and then I could install megapixels. And while megapixels, I think, is likely going to run totally fine, it seems like I'm having a bunch of different issues. Yeah, look at that. That's the camera, and it even has some kind of a breeze theme here. Okay, I can't take photos apparently. Well, that would have been too useful, wouldn't it? But the viewfinder worked. That's something. My current problem is that the settings menu. Okay, it took a photo now, so that was just a one-time issue apparently. But yeah, so I can use that. Let's just quit it, and there's no settings app here, and I can choose it here to reconnect to Wi-Fi. I can also just do it like that, but it seems like that I won't ever be able to reconnect this install to Wi-Fi. So apparently something with that upgrade from Plasma 5.19 to 5.20 didn't go well. I'm going to look at this later on in the coming weeks. I think it's best to give it some time. I'm sure Postmarket are going to fix those issues, and I'm glad that they are now moving on to 5.20, because it's so much better in general. And if we could have that new keyboard working fine on Postmarket, that would be one way to install Plasma Mobile without having the risk of the next update basically breaking your install and rendering it unusable, which is something that can and does happen with both Manjaro and KDE Neon. I had that happen to me, unfortunately, and yeah, there's no keyboard as well here. So yeah, so this update here went through, and for now it's still working, and I'm really not looking forward to doing anything more with this. Let me just try and start the browser so that I get out of this search menu. I shouldn't have hit that search bar. I know that's tough to get out of there. Don't know why I did that. Why do I keep doing that? Well, and now I can just briefly load my blog. And because that's my blog, and I write a weekly update, and sometimes write about other stuff like building software on Arch Linux ARM. And I'm on Twitter at linmobblog. I'm on Mastodon at linmob@fostodon.org. And please, if you are interested in the Pine Phone, maybe follow that. Also, I maintain this app list called, oh, wrong button, great, called linmobapps.frama.io, and it has 200 apps now. Let's just briefly load it. Yeah, the app list is loading, and soon we'll see that those are some 200 apps. But I will talk more about that in a future video. So for now, this is Plasma Mobile. I really wish that there was a user-friendly current distribution that wouldn't break for it, and that maybe more people would support the project so that it could progress faster, because it shows promise. And yeah, that's that. Thanks for watching. Have a great week, and goodbye.